Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome back to theCUBE's live coverage of Red Hat Summit Ansible Fest 2025. We are smack dab in the middle of day two of 3 days wall-to-wall coverage. I'm your host, Rebecca Knight, alongside my co-host and analyst, Rob Strechay. Rob, one of the buzzwords that we're hearing a lot is security here. We're talking a lot about data protection, resilience, and business resilience, too.
Yeah, I mean, I think when you talk about AI and you talk about AI is powered by data, and all of those things are just so key to how people are going to really get their ROI out of that data in a way that keeps them safe.
Exactly, exactly. With that, I would like to introduce our next guest. We have Vikram Kanodia, Vice President Technology and Cloud Partnerships at Cohesity. Welcome, Vikram.
Thank you for having me here.
And Evong Chung, Senior Director Ecosystems Tech Sales at Red Hat. Thank you so much for coming on theCUBE.
Nice to be here. Thank you for being here with us at Summit.
Yeah. So Vikram, I'm going to start with you because I want to hear about the Red Hat Cohesity partnership. But before we even get into the partnership and where it is today, talk a little bit about the cyber threat landscape right now that so many organizations are facing.
Absolutely. It's a menace. We liken it to pandemic, right? Everybody is going to get infected at some point. The question is, how quickly can you recover from it, right? And it's the same with enterprises, especially right now. You have nation state actors, you've got different companies trying to access the data. And all of us have to protect, help our enterprise customers protect that data, right? So that's where Cohesity comes in. We are a leader in AI-powered data security. We help customers recover from these cyber attacks in a fast way. We make them make the data secure. And that's where our partnership with Red Hat comes in as well. So we are very proud to have be protecting the world's data. As Sanjay Poonen, our CEO, says, we've got hundreds of exabytes of data in the protection as well.
Evong, kind of help us put in place where Cohesity sits, how the partnership came about, and where it stands today.
Yeah, absolutely, absolutely. So as you all know, there was significant disruption in the virtualization space last year. And so we have an offering on market called OpenShift Virtualization, which is the marriage between two really exciting technologies, Kubernetes and KVM, right? Which Red Hat has been investing in the community for a combined 30 years. So mature, tried and true, KVM or kernel-based virtualization is underpinning the cloud providers today. So tremendous scale that these technologies run at. And to take those two and marry them together, to take the power of KVM and the awesomeness of Kubernetes and unify them to a single platform for containers, for now VMs, and to take you to an open hybrid cloud model has been a story that has really resonated with our customers. With the disruption of last year, we recognize, to your point, that data is the lifeblood of the enterprise. And for us to be a trusted virtualization vendor, we need a powerful cyber resiliency story. So actually, Cohesity was one of the first companies that we reached out to from a partnership perspective. We have a longstanding partnership, but around this new opportunity, and really, like, what our joint message to our mutual customers that were in crisis would be. And so our CEOs connected. They've actually known each other for a very long time, Sanjay Poonen and Matt Hicks. And we talked about, like, how we could approach customers together to take them on this journey to a modern hypervisor.
So as you said, I mean, it is a journey. And as you also said, everyone's going to get infected. The question is how quickly you're able to bounce back, recover, and how really at the core is how resilient is your organization. So talk a little bit about how the CEOs came together and the teams came together and what your approach to customers is.
Yeah, maybe I can start and you can jump in. We've had a longstanding collaboration with Red Hat. Our platform runs on Red Hat Linux, right? But with the changes in the market, with customers looking to adjust their mix of virtualization technologies, you know, protecting OpenShift workloads is a demand that we see from a lot of our large enterprise customers. And as Evong said, our CEO Sanjay Poonen has a strong history in virtualization. He knows Matt Hicks. So with the changing dynamics of our customer and what they need, it made sense for us to work together. And that's how the partnership on protecting OpenShift containerized workloads came through. The third aspect of the partnership is we are also partnered with IBM, the parent company of Red Hat. IBM is an investor in Cohesity, and we are the only companies that they have OEM'd our product to take and modernize their Spectrum Protect customers using the Cohesity Data Protect as part of the Defender portfolio. So there's a lot of goodness between the two companies, from Red Hat Linux to us protecting OpenShift workloads to the IBM partnership as well.
Yeah, yeah, and to your question, we are connected at all levels of the organization, certainly our leadership as we discussed, but also our sales, our customer success organizations, and engineering as well. So part of reaching out to Cohesity was also to get their feedback and advice on where we should take the roadmap in the future as it pertains to data protection and cyber resiliency. So as we're innovating upstream in the Kubernetes community, we're getting their feedback and benefiting from their many years of experience in the virtualization space to make sure that really resonates with our enterprise customers.
So Cohesity made a small little acquisition.
Small.
A few billion, what's a few billion among friends, right? But help folks that are at home to understand how that's going and what it's kind of led to at this point. Because I think, again, as the changing threat landscape and, cyber resilience has become, a C-suite and sometimes, unfortunately, SEC-related type of event, help us understand how the things are going with Veritas and Cohesity now that you're one company.
Yeah, no, absolutely. Happy to talk about that. But as you said, right, it's a C-level discussion. It's a board-level discussion. Every board is looking at how secure the data is, right? So we completed the acquisition in December. So it's kind of nearly 6 months in, and it's going beyond our wildest dreams, right? The combination of Cohesity Veritas has produced the market leader. We've got over 13,600 customers, 85% of the Fortune 100, 70% of the Fortune 500. We're protecting hundreds of exabytes of data. The world's data is protected by Cohesity and Veritas, right? The way we are looking at the merger is it enables our customers, both the Veritas side of the house and the Cohesity side of the house, a more robust enterprise-grade platform, right? We have twice the engineering capacity as our nearest competitor, which allows us to innovate and protect the customer's data in a way that's differentiated than our competition. It allows us to partner with thought leaders like Red Hat, like IBM, like other partners to make sure we are taking an ecosystem approach to protecting our customers. So net-net, we are very happy with the acquisition. A lot of goodness coming in for our joint customers and looking forward to serving our joint customers even in a better way.
So just to piggyback on that a little bit, Cohesity rapidly grown number one in data protection, 13,000 enterprise customers, more than $1.7 billion in revenue. There's of course the merger, but what else is driving this momentum, would you say?
So I think as Evong said, right, data is the lifeblood of organizations, right? I mean, the amount of data being generated day in, day out is increasing. And as the data increases, the paradigm to protect this data also increases. So really the growth driver here is how can we protect the world's data? And that's the mission that I wake up in the morning and think about all the large customers that have trusted their data to us, how can we live up to that responsibility and protect the data, right? So that's one. The second thing is with AI, typically backup data used to be dark data. Enterprises did not know what's sitting in this backup data. Cohesity's unique architecture allows customers to peek inside this backup data and analyze it. We are the only company in our industry that NVIDIA has invested in because they love the technology. And the next frontier that we want to serve our customers on is enabling them to look at this backup data and do analytics on this data and generate meaningful business insights on the data. So that's what particularly excites me on where this industry is going and where we are going.
You want to add or you?
Oh, yeah, yeah, go sure, ahead. Absolutely.
Yeah.
So the majority of my career at Red Hat has actually been in the public sector, working with U.S. federal agencies. So I can't tell you how much this resonates with the conversations that I've had with CIOs of agencies that, the cyber threat is so much top of mind. And that's why I think our partnership is so exciting, because we can take, the cyber resiliency feature set that Cohesity brings to the table, and through OpenShift and OpenShift Virtualization in a unified platform, take that from containerized workloads to VMs to now AI, And I think that's a really powerful story that you know, we can take our customers on that journey together.
So building off of that, one of the things I'm interested in is you're on the tech sales side of things, and you're helping people from a solutioning perspective. Mm-hmm. What are some of the solutions you see where Cohesity is really, you know, adding value to that whole overall solution?
Well, I'll say with virtualization. So, you know, Red Hat is used to being a disruptor in the data center, right? We bring in these emerging technologies and sort of disrupt the paradigm that has existed inside of a data center. But this motion with virtualization is a little bit different because it's more of a displacement, right? And so we learned early on that, like, we need to work with the trusted advisors that already exist in the data center if we're going to be successful. Customer doesn't want to have to retool their entire ecosystem to be able to work with OpenShift virtualization. And that's why we were very intentional about reaching out to the market leaders, as we had talked about before. You know, our CEO, Matt Hicks, reached out personally to these market leaders to say, let's work together to have a single solution, right? An open ecosystem approach. You all know that Red Hat is all about open source, and the great thing about open source is it breeds open standards, right? And so these open standards, I think, you know, given the context of the situation that we're in, is really meaningful because they help lower vendor lock-in and give those customers freedom of choice. So I think that message, the open ecosystem approach, working with the market leaders, and the power of this platform is really resonated with our customer base.
Describe, Evong, the mindset of the people that you work with from the customer standpoint. I mean, as you said, you worked with a lot of heads of federal agencies, and obviously they're aware of the threat, but there's also a certain kind of throw your hands up in the air feeling about, I would imagine, just because if it is inevitable, why am I even working to keep it at bay? How do you talk to them about what the threats are, and how do you describe their mindset and their awareness around them?
Yeah, I mean, so definitely not throwing our hands up on national security. So, I mean, obviously, yeah. and actually in my new role, I have much more of a global purview, which has been great. And the themes are not, they're universal, right? So they are not unique to public sector at all. I mean, the cyber threat is real, right? We are under constant attack every moment of every day. And, you know, thinking about security at every layer of the technology stack is super, super important. But, you know, to the initial conversation, like, it all starts with the data. Like, that is the lifeblood. And that's why it is so important to have a strong story about how we're going to protect the data. Yeah.
So, I mean, the whole landscape, I mean, just building off of that, I mean, globally, and Cohesity has some numbers to this, so I'll let you comment on this. But I think from a perspective, I used to say when I was dabbling in this space before that, well, if you think you haven't been hit, you've already been hit.
Yeah.
Like, it's not if, or, I mean, I hate the saying of, it's not if, it's when kind of thing, but it really is. And in fact, it's when did it happen, not is it going to happen kind of thing. What are you seeing, you know, again, from the industry and perspective? Because cyber resilience is more than just backup. It's because there's RTO and RPO, and how am I going to bring things back? And then how do I bring everything up in a state that it's now usable again?
Absolutely. You know, what we see, and we do research on this all the time, right? And our customer kind of reviews indicate 90% of enterprises have been hit by an attack, right? And many of them have paid millions of dollars sometimes to kind of recover their data back, which is kind of mind-boggling, right? Like, it angers me that we have customers have to pay to get their data back. Where Cohesity fits in is, like, we think of the five S's, right? Cohesity is number one, speed to recovery. We are one of the fastest recovery platform. So when your platform is down through cyber resilience, how soon can you bring back the system, right? So that's one of our key differentiators. The second is simplicity. How easy it is to bring back your system. We have a single pane of control. Customers can look at all the workloads, whether VMs or virtualization or data, and coordinate all that recovery back. Third is scale, right? We've got large customers. We are bringing back hundreds of petabytes of data. It has to be orchestrated in the right way, to your point, right? And then the fourth is secure. Like, how can we make sure we can detect early signs of data breaches before it happens and coordinate with other parties in the ecosystem? And finally, it's the smarts, right? How can we take a Gen AI approach? So that's the five S's that we look at. how Cohesity works with customers' data.
So final question, looking ahead, where do you both see the greatest need for continued innovation between Red Hat and Cohesity, especially around and the intersection of AI and cloud native infrastructure?
Well, maybe I can start and feel free to jump in. So I think we continue to kind of want to meet the customers where they are, right? As customers adopt newer virtualization technologies, we want to make sure we are their chosen partner to protect these virtualization technologies. So we will continue to partner with Red Hat on making sure our solution to protect Red Hat workloads are the best in class. And we'll continue to co-innovate with them on how we can leverage Gen AI, Red Hat Linux platform, and all the innovation that Red Hat is doing to bring it to our customers.
And I think, so right now, over the past year, the initial focus of our customers has really been addressing like an immediate cost situation, right? But they're looking at this as an opportunity for long-term modernization, whether it be to an open hybrid cloud model, towards adopting containers or AI. And so I think our partnership, you know, conveys through all of those models, and we'll continue to work together to make sure that, you know, we give the customer like the single solution that can carry them from the future, address their current need, but carry them through to their future.
Perfect note to end on. Thank you both, Vikram and Evong. Pleasure having you on the show.
Thank you for having us.
I'm Rebecca Knight for Rob Strechay. Stay tuned for more of theCUBE's live coverage of Red Hat Summit Ansible Fest. You're watching theCUBE, the leader in enterprise tech news and analysis.